determine whether the transformation is rigid. Now, if the transformation is rigid, the only thing that changed from triangle ABC to triangle A prime, B prime, C prime is its orientation. The size should still be the same. And these triangles, I'm looking at them, yeah, they might be, they might not be. What I like to do is I like to look at it in terms of distance. And it turns out that if the distances for all three pairs of corresponding sides are the same, well, then you have a rigid transformation. Now I'm going to first look at AC and A prime C prime. So just looking at AC, let me get a different color here. Okay, now segment AC is 2 and then 4. A prime C prime, 2 and 4. So this means that segment AC and A prime C prime, they're the same length. And what I'm doing is I'm kind of doing the Pythagorean theorem, which is also the same as calculating the distance, but I'm just doing it informally. Because if two triangles are 2 by 4 for the two lengths of the sides here, I know that they have to be the same distance. And the reason why is it's the same calculation. Because let's say c squared equals 2 squared plus 4 squared. See, this is the same calculation for both triangles. So you know this c value has to be the same. And just I'll go ahead and work this problem out. C squared equals 4 plus 16. C squared equals 20, C equals square root of 20. And see, that applies to both triangles. So this AC and A prime C prime are both the same length of radical 20. So you can apply the same type of thinking to the other sides of the triangles. Let's look at AB next. That one's 2 and then 3. And then A prime B prime. That one's 3 and then 2. Now, by the same reasoning of the first pair of sides with AC and A prime C prime, we have 2, 3 and 2, 3. So let's say it's C squared again, and it's going to be 2 squared plus 3 squared. And that applies to both sides, because you have 2 by 3 and 2 by 3 here. So that equals 4 plus 9, which is 13, and that's for C squared. So C equals square root of 13. And that applies to A prime, B prime, and AB. So those two sides have the same measure also. Now, let's look at BC. So this is 2 and then 5. And this is 2 and then 5. So you can see the pattern, right? Since you have 2, 5 and 2, 5, you know you're going to have the same distance. So let's say it's C squared equals 2 squared plus 5 squared. C squared equals 4 plus 25. C squared equals 29. C equals square root of 29. So that means the distance of the segment BC and B prime C prime is square root of 29. Okay, so turns out that all three pairs of corresponding sides have the same measure. That means you have a rigid transformation.